Hey guys, this is Scratch Master with another tutorial. This tutorial, well, this will be the actually first video of a sequence of tutorials from like the very basics of Scratch. So starting from point zero, and we're gonna move on. So the other two tutorials I made, which were the simple maze and the simple calculator, those are gonna be my first series on a how-to, so I'm gonna make how-to videos after I'm done the simple Scratch tutorials. So we shall get started. So step one is first opening Google Chrome or any browser of your choice. Then on the search bar, you will have to type scratch.mit.edu. You could also search Scratch. On a Google search. So then we come to the screen. MasterCard 786 is my account for many Scratch games. I am pretty good at Scratch. Many projects. Okay. So let's get started. So in this tutorial, I'm just going to be teaching you how to get Scratch and all that. So all you have to do is get Scratch is just make an account. If you prefer the online version, you could do this by clicking Join Scratch. When you click Join Scratch, just type your username, choose a password, and confirm the password. Okay, and then confirm the password. Just write simple stuff. If you're a male, female, or if you're something else. Yep. Then type your country. Let's say, Turkey, why not? Parents or guardian email address, write your parents or guardian email address. Some people don't do this, some people do, your choice. And then you click next. So when you click next, you join Scratch. Sorry about the phone call. So you join Scratch. Then click OK, let's go. If you're someone that does not like using the internet, or you have like a certain megabyte limit of your plan, then just on Google search Scratch 2.0. well, that's my version that I currently have, the latest version of the date, which is December 16, 2014. So Scratch 2.0 download offline, and this will give you some links where you could download or get information about the Scratch apps. And when you go to the Scratch offline editor, so you need Adobe Air. Well, with the real version, let's say, of Scratch, I could not download it because I had a problem with Adobe Air. But you should actually first try it if you still have a similar problem to what I had. Well, I couldn't download this app somehow, some reason, I don't know. So then I had to go on SourceForge, and I eventually did a lot of surfing and found one. And sorry, I said SourceForge before, I meant SoftOnic. So just click the link of SoftOnic. Came here, Scratch 2.0, 330 programs. I went down, 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 kept searching. I couldn't find anything at first, so I decided to just get the 1.4 version. It's technically the same thing, so you don't really need to worry. Again, if you get Adobe Air, it will be better for you. And that's all you need to know about the first tutorial. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Please like and subscribe too. And by the way, I just wanted to get this out. Before, my name used to be The Scratch Master. Well, now I have decided on a new name, which is, I don't know, I'm still thinking about it, but it's most likely going to be The Chosen Developer. I really liked The Scratch Master, but then another guy took the name with all lowercase letters, and it was like a day before I made my Scratch Master account, like a year back or something. So, yeah, The Chosen Developer. Subscribe. Bye.